Blessed is our God, always, now, and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, O God, glory to you, O heavenly King, comforter of the spirit of truth, who are present in all places and filling all things, the treasury of good things and giver of life. Come and abide in us, cleanse us of every stain, and save our souls, O good one.
Amen. Holy God, holy might, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious to us, mercy and Master, forgive our transgressions. Holy Lord, consider our weaknesses and yield them for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
Glory.
In you, O Lord, I place my trust. You will do evil over my God. Hasten to help me, Lord, and my salvation.
Lord, by my God, and I have seen a soul's thirst for you, and fill all my body on the faith. And go, and so let it trap us, but in the eyes of the water, so did I come before you in your holy place, and see the power and glory that I am. Since your love is better than life itself, I will trust you in you. So shall I bless you as long as I live, and lift up my hands to call upon you. My soul shall be full as with choice. And joyful words of praise me. As I lay on my path, I remember you, and meditate upon you throughout the early watches, that you became for me the health of mine, and that in the shelter of your wings I'll find my way. My soul thirsts for you, and your right hand holds me up. But as for those who saw my love today, and made me sacred to the depths of the earth, let me give it over to the sword, the prey of javelins they shall be. But the king shall rejoice in God, and all who swear by him shall be worthy of the mouth of liars as well. I meditated on you throughout the early watches, and you became for me the help and work, and it shall fill your wings up behind your life. My soul comes to you in your right hand, holding up. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to your God. Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy, Lord of mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always, forever and ever.
O Lord, God of my salvation, day and night I cry out before you. Let my prayer reach out to you, and your ear to my plea, O Lord. My soul is filled with trouble, and all my feet close to Hades. I'm threatened with us to go down to the pit. I was like a man who gnawed in hell, left for death, like a son who left alive in the grave. Age, you remember no more, for there is that away from your hand. You have cast me down to the deepest abyss and into darkness and the shadow of death. Your anger was a burden upon me before you rose over me. You took my breath away from me, and you made me live since the dead. I was closed in and could not escape my eyes. You're dealing with distress. I cried out to you, O Lord, on the day I stretched out my hands to you. But when you were martyrs for the dead, our condition drank among the senior prayers. Does anyone see your love in the grave when the truthfulness and the mist of perdition? Right or wrong, turn around in darkness, or in your justice, and the land of Libyan. And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, and to whom my prayer shall rise at dawn. Why, O Lord, do you reject my prayer? Why do you hide your face and wait? I am wretched and troubled, since my youth I was raised out of the mouth, humbled in distress, and plight. Plagues have swept over me, and your terrors have left me shaken. They surround me like waters all day, and they close in upon me from all sides. You have distanced from me, friend, and they surround my comfort, so wretched am I. O Lord God, my salvation, day and night, I pray out before you. Let my prayer reach out to you, and your ear to my request, O Lord.
Bless the Lord, my soul, may all that is in me must adore me. Bless the Lord, my soul, and forget not all your sin. He pardons all your sins and heals all your infirmities. He ransoms your life from corruption and crowns you with his love and mercies. Who fills your longing with what is good and you reach with his renewed speech. The Lord performs deeds of kindness and vindication for all the above. He has made his praise known to Moses and his will to Israel's children. The Lord is born of compassion and mercy, long suffering and merciful. His contention is not forever, nor will his anger always last. He has not dealt with us as our sins demand, nor does he with their ease indeed. For as high as the heavens reigned over the earth, so far as the Lord descended his love from those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed his sins from us. As kind as the Father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself knows well how we perform the memory, we are only made of them. A man, he stays to them a glass of the flower of the field, so valuable. The Lord has reached us over him, and he is mine, and never shall I know the place again. But the love of the Lord is for all eternity, and to all eternity we wish to be again. And justice is upon the children of children to keep his covenant and remember his love to obey him. The Lord has established his throne in heaven over all things his kingdom is supreme. Bless the Lord, all you angels, be strong and mighty, those who obey his word on hearing his sign of his decree. Bless the Lord, all you his powers, who pretend to obey his will. Bless the Lord, all you his works, and every place his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. Bless the Lord, all my soul, and every place his
dominion. O Lord, hear my prayer, and your truthfulness, and heed to my plea, and your righteousness answer me. And enter not into judgment, but your servants, since of all living, none is just in your sight. The enemy has hounded me down, he has crushed my life into the ground, he has forced me to live in darkness, I have long dead. My spirit faints with grief, and the living my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old, and meditate on all your deeds. I find that the works of your hands I stretched out my hand to you, like a march down my soul, first to you. Make haste to answer me, O Lord, my spirit is still me. Turn not your face away from me, lest I be like this in the pit. Grant that I may hear your steadfast love at dawn, for I have placed my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I have lifted up my soul to you. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies. It is to you that I have fled. Teach me to hear your word, for you are my God. May your good spirit lead me on a straight path. For the sake of your name,
unity of the holy churches of God and for the unity of all, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop and Father Savas, the Honorable Presbyterate for the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, for the President, for all the public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and man, for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our all-holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another our whole life to Christ our God. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. God is the Lord, and he revealed himself to us. Blessed is he who comes. Martyr, and he goes, in
Christ, we've been waiting for the resurrection and the grace of the Lord by your knowledge. transgress in your ways, and the ungodly shall turn back to you.
And you remember that you don't need to God, the government, salvation, and the time to pray, and the rest of your righteousness.
Oh Lord, you shall open my lips and my mouth with your praise.
We desire the sacrifice that we give you, and I'll be pleased to go over and honor you, sir.
Sacrifice to God's work, the spirit of the Lord, and all the world, and all the spies.
To the Lord, Lord, you have been blessed, you desire that the wealth of your youth be filled.
And you will be pleased with the sacrifice and righteousness of God, and to one more offering.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
saveth, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Mercy.
Venerate our awful, meek, and our most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another in our whole life, to Christ our God.
Lord.
For all the powers of heaven, praise you and offer up glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Yeah.
Right.
reverence and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For pious and Orthodox Christians, let us pray to the Lord. For all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, the president, for all the public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this parish and city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord. Peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Son of God, who did rise from the dead,
fuoco predati.
This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it.
Risen from the dead.
Keep our fetters, Simeon, doth grow on eon long.
Because the days are evil. Therefore, do not be foolish, but understand. will of the Lord is. And do not get drunk with wine, for that is debauchery, but be filled with the Spirit, addressing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody to the Lord with all your heart.
that ever guarded by your might, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Anonymous, Minis, the Kyrios.
manger of necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. For a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us ask of the Lord.
His kingdom shall
Let us stand aright. Let us stand in awe. Let us be attentive that we may present the holy offering in peace.
Thank you. panagias ac agui perfoitenis, en dulcis espinis immorteo nobis, que ai partenum mariae.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Through the grace, compassion, and love of mankind, of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good and life-creating Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages. Let us be attentive. The holy gifts for the holy people of God, Daiyat Isaias, Shiataya Shati.
Oh.
name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christ is in our midst.
He is
It's a beautiful thing to recognize signs, brothers and sisters in Christ, especially the young ones here. I'm not sure if any of you remember that it was the first Sunday of the month, but somehow when this comes out, all of you just gather right down here. It's a beautiful thing. Recognizing the signs. You know, when the rainbow came, they knew that it was the end of the flood. When a deacon walks in and he has a staff, that means who's coming after him? A bishop, that's right. See, recognizing signs is important. So we have been talking about who? Who we've been talking about? The prophets, right. And they were who? Well, I mean, yeah, those are the prophets. But who? What was their role? What was their job? They were messengers. They were storytellers. Messengers are angels. It's a little different. Messengers come from the throne of God that speak to the prophets sometimes. Sometimes the message comes directly from the Lord to the prophets. But nevertheless, the prophets were sent, you know, the angels are sent to like one person or one man or sometimes to a few people to do whatever. The prophets are sent to who? Us. Right. Good. And they're supposed to tell what? What are they supposed to say? Whatever God tells them, the word of God. That's right. Very good. Whatever God tells them to say. If God sends the word to a prophet to say, that he's got to say that. You know? And sometimes some of the prophets, when they spoke words to the people, that's what they heard. They didn't hear anything that they could understand. They heard these cryptic messages that they couldn't quite understand. So, we talked about who last night? Show me who we talked about. That guy. What's he wearing? Okay, good. What's his name? Jonah. Very good. I'm not going to go through that. Good to remember. Very good. I was actually going to just go kind of like right around the horn a little bit, but the times and the seasons dictate something otherwise. So we're going to skip a couple. We're going to go from Jonah, and we're going to skip to the prophet Micah.
Oh, that's my mom.
The prophet Micah.
Yeah, Micah's my friend.
There we go. So, that's a good thing. So, but the prophet Micah, where is he? Can you find him? Who can find him? He's up there. Go ahead, where is it? He's which one are we doing? This one? Over here. Yeah, well, it's kind of greenish. It's like almost a teal. Red on the outside, greenish kind of teal on the inside. He's three over to the left from Jonah. You follow Jonah and you follow it, what is it, clockwise around, you know, you will find light. See him? He's got the scroll in his left hand, and he's kind of have his fingers pointing right at him. You know, almost like he's going, "Hey, what's up?" You know. So that's Micah right there. And the important reason why we're talking about Micah now, we'll hear. So the prophet Micah is among the shortest books in the Old Testament. It's among not the shortest book, but he is. Among the lesser prophets, there are greater prophets and lesser prophets. Among the lesser prophets, he is ranked sixth among them, and his story is in all of your Bibles. Doesn't make a difference. If it's an Orthodox Study Bible, if it's a King James Bible, you will find the book of Micah. Short, seven chapters. It'll take you like 10 minutes to read it. There's a lot in it, though. A lot in it. Okay? And who was he? He was a man sent by the Lord to speak to a specific group of kings. And he lived around the same time, almost the same time, as the prophet Isaiah. And prophet Isaiah, by the way, for your own purposes, prophet Isaiah, if I remember, is, you see the guy with the hat, it's prophet Daniel. Prophet Isaiah is the one to his left.
He lived almost around the same time as the prophet Isaiah, and they had almost a similar message, except the prophet Isaiah's message was much more broad, and his takes much more time to tell, because there's a lot more revelations and visions. Micah is very short, and his message was very short and sweet. He looked at the people of Judea. He looked at the people of Samaria. Where was Samaria? What's Samaria? What are the people of Samaria? No, Samaria. Samaria is the name of the place. Was that? What? In other words, what is the significance of the people of Samaria? You've heard me say, like, the Good Samaritan, but this person was a Samaritan. That means they're from Samaria. Saint Pukini, the Samaritan woman. Who is the Samaritan? What's Samaria? Do we know what this is? These were people, this is important that you understand this. These were people that came from the Jews. They were at one point, the people of Samaria were among the Jews. And then somebody from Samaria decided, and a group of people from Samaria, one of the tribes, decided that they wanted to be with people outside of the Jews, outside of God's chosen people. And so they were having families and growing together and getting married to people that were not Jewish, and they didn't want to become Jewish. So they were in this own little region, because they, at that point, according to the law of Moses at that time, that was not, they couldn't do that. If you were going to marry someone, they had to come in. They had to be a part. They didn't want to be a part. You all know. And so the people from Samaria, thank you. The people from Samaria were considered to be the Xeni, for those of you that like that word. They were considered to be the Xeni of the Greeks versus non-Greeks among some of us. They kind of looked at people and they said, oh, you're from Samaria. Nevertheless, they were half Jewish. And just because they were not from Judea, just because they were not from Judah and Israel, from the kingdom, God still had a message for the people of Samaria, and Micah was the one sent to give it to them. Not just to the people of Samaria, but also to the kingdom of Judah. And in this way, God, for the first time, Micah is probably one of the first prophets that was sent to be preaching to people who were outside the kingdom of Judah, who were outside the Jewish people. Because the Jews would say, hey, what's this message for Samaria? Why are you even talking to them? What is this message here? And what was his message? This is going to be a theme, so I want you to remember. Remember this. The first thing that a prophet says to people is what? You, whoever he's talking to, have sinned. It's the first message of any prophet. You have sinned. It's kind of a tough message to hear. But that was Prophet Micah's message. In fact, it was so serious, he actually talks about, in his first couple chapters, the destruction of Israel, the end of the kingdom of Judah, the end of the people of Samaria. And he says, why? You have sinned. And he talks about how the righteous have left. There's no more righteous there. And when he goes through his second part of the book, he talks about how God says, but it's okay. It's okay that you have sinned. It's okay that there's none righteous left. Because guess what I'm going to do, according to the prophet Micah? I'm going to bring my Savior. I'm going to bring the person. And this is what he says. Listen to this. But you, Bethlehem Ephrathah, this is from the book of Micah, though you be little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth unto me that that is going to be a ruler in Israel, whose goings forth have been from old, from everlasting. He will stand and shepherd his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God, and they will live securely, for then his greatness will reach to the ends of the earth. He was writing this, Bethlehem Ephrathah. What's why is Bethlehem important? Why is the little town of Bethlehem important? Because Jesus was born there. That's right. And Prophet Micah was living around the same time as the Prophet Isaiah. If you don't know when that is, that's 800 years before Jesus was born. 800 years before Jesus was born. And Micah was sent to the kingdoms of Israel and the kingdom of Samaria to tell them, hey, it's coming. Shape up. Now, none of them that were alive were going to see it, but nevertheless, these are the prophets giving this message. And here he is talking about how from Bethlehem Ephrathah, from him, from there, the Savior's going to come. Who will do what? Stand and shepherd his flock. And what does Jesus call himself? The good what? The good shepherd. This is how important these writings are. This is how important these messages are. So the last thing that Micah does in this short chapter, it's almost going to take you shorter to read it than it is I'm speaking about it. But the last thing he does in his book is that he exhorts us to live humbly and to sin no more. Why is it important to sin no more? Why is it important? Why is it important? Somebody else. Why is it important to sin no more? Why is it important? Good. It's bad. That's right. And we want to be good before the Lord. We want to give him our best. Sinning is not okay. Good job. Okay? Now, the people who heard this message, they loved it, right? No, they didn't love it. They heard it, but they just dismissed it, right? No, they didn't do that either. No, in fact, unfortunately, when they heard this message from the prophet Micah, they grabbed him, they imprisoned him, and then they killed him. I'm not going to tell you how, but they did. So when we read later, as we are going to during Holy Week, we're going to read how Jesus was condemning the Jews for killing the prophets. He's not the only one, by the way. But when Jesus condemns the Jews for killing the prophets, for slaying those that he himself sent out of love to the kingdom of Judah, when he says those words, you're going to remember the prophet Micah. That there was one man that was sent to give a message of a wake-up message, a warning message, but also a message of hope that help is coming. And when they heard this message, instead of rejoicing that there was going to be a Savior, they literally shot the messenger. You know that phrase, don't shoot the messenger. They literally killed the messenger. We commemorate Prophet Micah, and we are going to hear that those words, you Bethlehem Ephrathah, that those words you're going to hear as we get closer and write about our Christmas Eve service and the services of the hours that we're going to do right before. So make sure that you're coming to those services so that you can hear how the church brings all of these images and all of these prophecies together to show how Jesus is going to come. So that's the prophet Micah we're talking about. Jonah, right there, and the prophet Micah, we have a whole lot more to go through. So God bless you. Thank you for being so attentive. And please let us now arise and say together our communion prayer.
I believe and confess, Lord, that you are truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. I also believe that this is truly your pure life, and this is truly your precious blood. Therefore, I pray to you, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, in word and deed, known and unknown, and make me worthy without condemnation to partake of your pure sins. For the forgiveness of sins and for life eternal. Amen. How shall I, who am unworthy, enter into the splendor of your saints? If I dare to enter into the bride's chamber, my clothing will accuse me, because it is not my way. And being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angels. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul and save me. Loving Master, Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holiness lead to my condemnation because of my unworthiness, but for the cleansing and sanctification of soul and body, and the pledge of the future life and kingdom. It is good for you to cling to God and to place in him the hope of my salvation. Receiving you today, Son of God, as a partaker of your mystical supper, I will not do your mystery to your masters, nor will I lend you the gifts and duties, but as anybody like to send to you, Lord,
the fog of day will be still scared. God is close to death with the fear of God, with faith and with love draw near.
Oh, man.
Sos un Dios de lapsu, que erois on ignorum Iesu, O God, save your people, and bless your inheritance.
Thank you.
May he who led Christ, the true God, through the intercession of his all pure and all immaculate the Holy Mother, the power of the precious and life-giving cross, protection the honor of the body of the powers of heaven, supplication the honor of the glorious prophet and forerunner John the Baptist, holy glorious and praiseworthy apostle, holy glorious Christ and martyrs from heaven, without the Father, God, our righteous Father, John Chrysostom, the Archbishop of Constantinople, the clergy, the celebrated, the holy righteous ancestors of God,
the most robust and active youth program in the whole Archdiocese.
I just want to also remind you, all the people, next week is our own Stewardship Sunday. If you have not filled out your pledge card, please do so. There's some in the back. Bring it with you. And as we normally do, we will be offering a prayer that the Lord will multiply and accept the gifts and also multiply them so that we can do as much as we can with them. Lastly, as we are normally accepting donations within this parish, it has been our tradition to accept donations on behalf of St. Barbara, St. Sabas, and St. Nicholas. We've been doing this since I first got here. It has been the tradition since we started our Christmas dinner. It has been our tradition that many of those donations that come for these feasts have been given to the Christmas dinner, to the Agape Fund for the Christmas dinner. In addition to all of those donations, and anyone that would like to give donations to the Agape Fund, so that we can help defray the cost of the dinner itself, Barbara Lee is also accepting donations so that we can give out gifts to the little children that come on Christmas Day. The local host is doing this, and Barbara Lee is the key point person involved in accepting those gifts and those donations as well. So she is. So between the two of us, if you want to give the gifts for the kids or help do the dinner, it's between myself and Barbara Lee. Please see us, and we can help direct you in that way. Just to keep it in your mind, it's coming. It's going to be here before you know. And as we do every year, we're going to be probably 500, 600 meals again. I can't imagine it going down at all. So let's keep our joy active with these things as we keep this feast going. There was a lot of announcements. I apologize for the length of them, but there was a lot to make sure that we remember for the coming weeks. Is there anything else that we have to remember? Then please rise and come forth to receive your blessing.